Now it's time for more supermarket secrets. News 8 is on your side this week, helping you to become a smarter and healthier shopper.
Here's consumer reporter Brian Roach.
Well, so far this week, we've told you about the science of the supermarket and why it's a good idea to check your sales receipt for any possible problems with sales tax. Now I'm joined by my colleague, 8 on Your Side medical reporter Susan Shapiro, going to tell us a little bit about shopping smart, shopping healthy.
That's right, Brian. Good nutrition begins with making good choices here at the supermarket, but that's not always so easy. It can be difficult when you see all kinds of products that claim to be low fat, natural, or organic. So we tried to sort it out for you.
It's ever expanding.
The organic and natural food section is growing in many local supermarkets. The wood-toned floors and special lighting give it that earthy feel.
This category here, as far from a grocery standpoint, is probably the fastest growing category in a store.
People are more conscious about what they're putting in their bodies, and they want to be more careful about what they're giving their children.
Mommy wants to make a butterscotch nut squash recipe.
Amy Fretz of Lancaster is one of those people. The mother of three says she does about 75% of her shopping in this part of the store, although it can be pricier.
It tastes better. I feel better feeding it to my family, and especially having three children.
But don't be fooled into thinking all of the items in this section are low calorie or low fat. Take, for instance, the Utz Natural Chips. They still have 140 calories for a 1 ounce size and 8 grams of fat. I got these out of the regular aisle. They have 150 calories and 9 grams of fat. These are cooked in sunflower oil, these in cottonseed oil.
You need to read the label and have some idea of what your calorie boundaries are, because otherwise you're going to wind up with a very high calorie food despite the fact that it's organic or natural.
Registered dietitian Jen Reed teaches people to read food labels and select healthy food at the supermarket.
It's a cholesterol-free source of protein.
She leads tours at Oregon Dairy for members of Universal Athletic Club in Lancaster.
I'm surprised how much you have to be aware, right, and really aware of some things that may be marketed as being healthy, but when you really look into it, maybe it's not quite as healthy as you think it is.
Take Skippy Natural Peanut Butter.
This one, when you turn it around, it has peanuts, sugar, palm oil, which is a saturated fat, and salt in it. When you compare it to something that says natural, like the Smucker's, this truly just has peanuts and a teeny bit of salt in it. It doesn't have the sugar or the palm oil in it.
And she says the bread you put that peanut butter on should be no more than 70 calories a slice.
And ideally, you're going to have 3 grams of protein and 3 grams of fiber for those 70 calories.
But some of that fiber may not be the real deal.
This one has cellulose fiber added to it. So it's a synthetically added fiber. It's not naturally occurring at all.
And products labeled Heart Smart or Heart Healthy can still have a good bit of sodium. It's recommended that you not have more than 23 milligrams of sodium a day.
These are definitely lower in sodium than some of their traditional products. But in my opinion, 360 milligrams of sodium per half a cup is still too high.
Reed recommends doing a lot of shopping on the perimeter of the supermarket, especially for fresh fruits and vegetables.
The thing that's nice about particularly the root vegetables is that when you roast them, because it's such a high heat, they caramelize. So their natural sugar that makes them a little higher in calories also gives them a sweeter taste.
And it's here and in the meat and dairy sections where she says you may want to opt for some organics.
If you're going to eat the skin on it, or it's something that you eat a lot of, whether it be meat or dairy, you're definitely better off getting an organic product, because there is a benefit there without the hormones and the additives.
So this is where you want to try to spend a lot of time in the supermarket, in the produce section, and try to find a new vegetable or fruit each week. You know, Brian, we all tend to buy the same things week in and week out, wouldn't you say?
Oh, absolutely.
So try to mix it up a little. Instead of always going for the white potato, try the sweet potato, not just at Thanksgiving. This will give you more beta carotene.
That one's better for me. All right,
yep.
Susan, thank you very much. You can see our entire 3-part supermarket secret series on our website, WGAL.com. Back to you.
Thanks, guys.
Yeah.